So are there any contemporary artists that you listen to today, and are they addressing the issues you think that need to be addressed?
Oh, absolutely. Peter and I move in different worlds, but in the world that my daughter has introduced me to through an agency called Music to Life, I'm well aware that folk music's concept, its activism, has morphed its way into even country music and hip-hop. I mean, there's Baby J, you know, out of Texas. There's Jaziri X. There's Carolyn Malachi. These are names that are perhaps not on the national radar yet, but they're addressing things like neighborhood violence. They're addressing ecological, Tim Blessed, Carolyn Malachi, women's rights. Peter's got a whole experience from the Dakota
I was just with Bethany in South Dakota, in the Black Hills, and she really is one of the leaders of this effort. And we had 2 days of performances, and there were a few of us who were non-native performers. But some of the people that came in, Knock O'Bear, is extraordinary. He's American, but he identifies with his Aztec ancestry, and he is very, very, very popular. And from Australia, Xavier Rudd came in, who is unbelievable and has very strong advocacies about the Aboriginal tribes there. So, and there is a kind of an advocacy that connects all that with the survival of the planet and the spirituality that we must embrace if we're to get people's hearts in tune with what is needed in order to really be together to counter this kind of very, very serious, irreversible climate change problem.
And I think that was part of the message that runs through the book as well, is that advocacy with no hope is pretty assaulting and leads to a certain kind of despair. But Mary always said, yes, of course it's protest music in the true Latin identification, pro and test. You're attesting to something in a positive way. And I think much of the music that Peter and I both appreciate in the younger generation is that which points to a future together.
So you don't see activism as dying. You see that it's growing, but in different ways. It's not as mainstream as it was.
No, because they don't have the same kind of media access that would make everybody know Blowing in the Wind or Fight a Hammer.
Right.
Now, you do have these pockets, and these are important pockets. And so you'll find me, because I'm this inveterate activist, up there with Bethany in an anti-fracking gathering, as well as Valentina, or up in Madison, Wisconsin.
Or Occupy Wall Street.
Or Occupy Wall Street.
Or Occupy Wall Street Journal.
There you go, which you're doing right now, very beautifully.
Let us announce that.
Right. Wonderful. What a delight it has been to have you both here today. Thank you so much.
Thank you
so much, Tanya.